Hello, my name is Diana Henry, and I am the education assistant at the African American Museum of Iowa. Today, I'm going to share a short story with you, and then we're going to do an activity. So let's begin. Today, I want to begin with a short story about Maya's quest to learn about a craft. Mom, my art teacher showed us some batik art today. She said it's practiced in countries such as China, India, Indonesia, and West Africa. Have you ever heard of batik art in West Africa? Well, yes, I have, Maya, heard about that. Here's a map that shows some West African countries where that art form is practiced. So Mom, how do they do it? Well, it's an ancient art in which they use dyed cloth with different layers of colored wax. One method of doing this is called adire, eleko, where starch paste is used. The paste is most often made of the cassava plant, which is turned into a flour. They add rice, alum, and some copper sulfate, and they put it all together and they boil it to produce a thick paste. Then they traditionally go ahead and freehand draw the designs, and they do that by using a feather or a thin stick or a piece of fine bone, sometimes a metal or a wooden comb-like tool. The traditional dye is usually indigo from a plant which grows throughout Africa. Now, in many places, these are now cultivated in different varieties, and they produce a variation of dark blue color. Once the paste resists is dry, the fabric is dyed in large clay pots or large pits that are in the earth. After drying, the paste is then scraped off to reveal a white or blue pale design. Mom, can you show me some pictures of those designs, what those designs look like? Well, let's go to the library and see what we can find. So Maya and her mother, they go to the library. Now they're in the library and they're looking at some things in different books. And Mom says, well, here are some examples. And so they're looking at the examples, and the examples show a variety of different colors, not just the indigo. And Mama says, wow, look at all the different patterns and detail. Yes, if we look at this very closely, we're seeing that there are different kinds of patterns and details within the cloth. Now, the cloth, of course, is used for making different kinds of clothing. Sometimes it's used to make pillowcases, curtains. A variety of different kinds of things can be done with the fabric. Would you like to make some batik art, Maya? Well, yes. Great, because Mrs. Henry is going to show you how and show some other kids how to do the same thing. Okay, let's get started. Now let's continue on Maya's quest.
Hello, boys and girls. We're going to continue with Maya's quest to learn more about batik art. And so today, I'm going to talk about some materials that you need first before we get started and some of the steps. So you're going to need to have a candlestick. I believe the materials that will be in your bag will be small little candlesticks. You're going to need to have an index card and a piece of cloth, a tray with paint in them, and a paintbrush, 2 cups with water to clean your brush and to wet the brush. Now, before we get started, you need to know some things in order to prepare for the activity. So, in order to do this activity, the first thing you're going to do, you're not doing anything yet, though. You're just following my listening to my instructions. So the first thing you're going to do, you're going to take your candle and you're going to draw your design. The next thing you're going to do is take your paintbrush. You're going to dip it in water and then you're going to swish it on the paint, whatever color you want. And then you're going to spread that smoothly across the design that you've already drawn. Okay? Now, after you do that, the second thing you're going to do is, using your cloth, you're basically going to do the same thing. So, think about what you want to draw. It could be a design. It could be like some of the designs that were on the PowerPoint I just went through. You can make a little horse. You can make a little dog, some flowers. You can make, draw a house, make a cat. Those are just some ideas. You could come up with some better ideas than I just came up with, right? Or some great design. You can do that too. So let's first take our candle and make it either design or some type of drawing. Okay? So follow along. You do yours, I'll do mine. Okay? Let's get going. But you know that you've made something on your index card. So now, you may want to go over that really good again, if you wish, to make sure it's going to stand out for you. And then, you're going to take your paintbrush, like I'm doing right now, dip it in some water, dip it on inside of one of the paint colors and smooth that across. Just go all over that. Now you can use one color. You can use more than one color. If you're going to use a second color, dip it into that water to clean that brush, like I'm doing right now. Put it in another color if you want another color. Swish it through that again. And I think I'm going to have a third color. I'm going to squish it in there again. And if that's kind of thin, put it back in there so you can get more of that color. And I think I want to have it totally go through and fill up this card with color. Through this. I want to fill this card up with color. I want to get all those areas where I made my drawing done. doing different colors, which is fine. As long as you clean your brush. Okay, I have totally filled up my card with color, and you will see on my picture and yours how the parts that had the wax candle on it, you now see the design that was put on with the wax candle. And so that design has come forward and the coloring has come backward. Now, if you recall in the PowerPoint, it talked about how the people in West Africa, they use a paste, they create a paste, and they use either a stick or a metal piece or a feather. And they dipped it into that paste and they drew their design. And after they did that, then they dipped it in the dye, and most of the dye was indigo dye, but now they also are creating other kind of colors. So they have a large pot that they dip it in to bring out the color. But we're sort of making that type of thing on the index card, okay? Now, the next thing that we can do now, if you want to make a second one, that's fine too. But the next thing that we can do is take our cloth and do the same activity with our cloth, okay? Now, with your index cards, these are the ones that you're going to keep with you. You can keep those. But I was thinking, once we complete our cloth pieces, then what I would like for us to do is send them to the library, and eventually the librarians will put them all together to make a huge quilt with them. So let's start on making something with our cloth. So we need to create something, starting once again with your candlestick. Make some type of design on the cloth. Now this one here, you may want to think a little bit more about what you want to put on it, on this. I'm making my design. And I know you guys are gonna make something better than Mrs. Henry making on her design, right? Okay, once you finish that, taking your brush again, dip it into any other paint that you have in your paint tray, and you may want to get a lot of that on your paintbrush and smooth it across the cloth again. And you notice once again, your design is coming forward. Dip it into that water again and get some more of that paint. You want a lot of it on here because the cloth is a little thicker than the paper. But the design is coming forward. And you may want to think about how you want more colors. Dip it in that water and paint again. Dip it in that water, scoop up some of that paint, make it go through it again. Right now, I got two colors going on my cloth. With my designs coming forward, I think I want to make I'm going to go through and get a third color. Okay. Now, this is my design. Of course, it's not, I know, guys, it's not as lovely as yours are going to be. I'm looking forward to seeing the ones that you guys create when I visit the library. But I got my design here. Let me bring it up close to you. The two designs that I created. I'm bringing this up close so you can see it. So now you can see how that design, my first design on the index card. You can see how the white came forward and the paint is in the background. And now on the cloth, you can see how the white parts came forward and the paint is in the background. So once again, this is one way to create batik art. Remember that you can have all kinds of interesting and creative designs doing this. Remember that in West African country, what they did, they created a paste from plants, and they use tools such as a feather or a stick or a thin metal piece. They use that to dip it into the paste that they created from plant products, and then they made their design with that paste. Then they took it, the cloth, and they dipped it into the dye, and that dye was in large pots, and they pulled it out, and therefore they had their design, and they scraped off the starchy or pasty piece, and that's why you see that those designs that were in the PowerPoint came forward. What we did was an adaptation of that. We used our wax candle like the paste that they would have used. Okay, we use the paintbrush as the dye, painting with our paint as the dye. So that's our adaptation for this West African batik activity. Okay, a few more things I need to close out with today. One is that we really would like to share your batik art that was on the fabric
at the library. You can keep the index card, but we would like for your parents to return the design that you created on the fabric to the library so that the librarians, they can put them all together and make a large quilt. I hope you'll be willing to do that. Thank you so much.